गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फाइव स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू नर्वस सिस्टम. ऑल्सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई टॉट यू नर्वस सिस्टम बट फ्यू पोर्शंस वर स्टिल लेफ्ट. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद दोज पोर्शंस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू नो रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन. दिस इज एन ऑटोमेटिक रिएक्शन. इट हैपन्स सो फास्ट दैट वी डोंट गेट टाइम टू थिंक व्हाट हैड हैपेंड. इट हैपन्स बाय इटसेल्फ इवन इफ समबडी इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग एल्सवेयर. सच ऑटोमेटिक एक्शंस आर कॉल्ड रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन. In this case, says the message does not go to the brain. The spinal cord first senses the danger and then takes the action immediately to avoid any damage to the body. Like, I'll give you an example. Pulling away our hand, as soon as someone touches a hot object, or blinking when something enters into the eye, putting up your hand to stop something hitting your face, ducking to escape being hit. So these are certain types of reflex action. Before sending the message to the brain, your spinal cord, your nervous system of your body only start reacting vigorously. You can see what is happening in this video. See how the connections are being made. That's why we generally see how it's been trying to get that heat. They are trying. Like, once again, I will play the video. See how the message is being transferred. It's trying to touch or get hold of that hot object because he didn't had an idea that person, but as soon as the heat came, he automatically removed his hand. So this is what reflex action all about. Now comes to your sense organ. Information from outside world enters in your body through this sense organ. Information sent to the spinal cord for instant response. Yes, because spinal cord is a part of your nervous system. Then it's that relay station. Relay means the connection maintained with the spinal cord to the brain for further processing, because your brain need to understand what kind of reaction, what kind of situation you are there. There are five senses that helps us to know the surrounding, like the pictures I have given you, and already you know eye, ear, nose, your skin and your tongue. So let's come into eye. So this is the image of an eye which I have given you. Your eyes gives you the sense of sight. Your eyes and brain work together and help you to see things. Your eye is very sensitive and is like a round ball. It is found in a socket in the skull and it's been well protected. The eyelids, you have two eyelids. The eyelids protect the eyes from dust and bright light. Your eyes give you the maximum information about the world around you. They can differentiate color, shapes, size and distances of objects around you. The color part of your eyes is called the iris. Light passes first through the pupil, which is your space at the center of the iris. Behind the pupil is your lens, which helps you to focus the light from the object, and then it focuses the light onto the retina. Images of the object are thus formed on the retina. The retina has a special cells and are sensitive to light and color. A nerve is also there which helps in all this communication information. The name of this nerve is termed as optic nerve. See, the picture is given. You can see whatever I have told you. You can figure out iris, you can figure out the pupil, you can figure out the lens, you can figure out the optic nerve, you can figure out the retina. Then comes your ears. This is a diagram of a ear. Many much detailing is being done as the anatomy of ear, but you don't need to know so much of detailing. You just need to see the diagram. The part of the ear that is seen outside, that is being termed as your external ear or pinna. What is the function of the pinna? Pinna helps you in collection of sound. Middle ear also function to turn the sound wave into vibration. Yes, when we are getting the sound, it comes in form of wave and then it gets converted into vibration form. Sound comes into the inner ear as vibration and enters a small curled tube in the inner ear. It is coming into our ears, but it's entering into the small curl like tube like structure. Here nerve signals get created, then the brain understand as sound. First nerve signal will get created and then your brain is going to understand that yes, you heard something, which you can call it up to be a sound. Then comes your nose. The molecules of perfume mix with the air and reach your nose. Inside your nose are ends of nerves that detect the smell of these molecules. Messages are then sent to the brain through this nerve. Your brain finds out what is the smell about, and this is why you are able to smell that it's a smell of a perfume. So what are the features of nose? The space in behind our nose is known as olfactory epithelium. Contains special receptors which are sensitive to odor. Odor means smell. When smell receptors are stimulated, signals travel along the olfactory nerve to the olfactory bulb. Then signals sent from the olfactory bulb to the other parts of the brain, and then your brain interprets the smell and it can detect what kind of smell it is. Interpret to means understand. Then comes your tongue. Tongue is obviously meant for tasting. The surface of the tongue has many tiny bumps which are known as your taste buds. Taste bud contains your ends of the nerve. Nerve detect the four main kind of tastes and send the messages to your brain. And last sense organ which is included in your syllabus is your skin. See, this is the picture for the different layers of a skin, anatomical layers of a skin. Obviously from outside you cannot see. Outer layer is called epidermis. You can see the outer layer has been marked as epidermis. Second layer comes your dermis. Dermis, in that dermis region only, dermal region, you have nerve ending. Now third portion is also there, which has been found below dermis, which is known as hypodermis. But that you don't need to, for the timing, you don't need to know so much in details. But yes, you just know that hypodermis is present below the dermis. Now what happens is skin works with the brain and nervous system so that brain gets the message about what we are touching or who is touching you. Everything has to work with nervous system in one term. So with this I have come to an end of the chapter. So again, I have given you some work assignment like fill in the blanks and answer the question which you need to solve in your science worksheet copy. I repeat myself, you need to solve them in science worksheet copy. Okay, so let me tell, just dictate the fill in the blanks for you. Dash, first one, the dash from the outside world enters the body through sense organ. The sensory part sends tiny burst of electricity called dash. Two dashes are there. Dash work from the moment we wake up. Taste bud is made up of dash. Two dashes are there again. Outer layer of skin called dash. Outer ear is called dash. Space behind the nose is dash. Now number 6, outer ear is called dash, that is single dash, okay, not two dashes, it's single dash. Now you have 7 to solve fill in the blanks, but if you count the blanks you will get 10 only. So please solve it accordingly and answer the following question. I have given you 3, just try to solve them, take the guide from your book and solve them. What is nerve signal, which is for 1 mark? What is reflex action, which is for 2 marks? What is taste bud, which is for 2 marks? And all these things has to be done in your science worksheet copy. So thank you. If you have any queries or doubt, you need to mail me. You know my mail ID, ankita.sma@outlook.com. And you need to mail your regular science work assignment also in this ID. Okay, because no other way of communication will be entertained.